Hello, Natsakimura here. I and my friend John Bradley has been telling this for many years.
OAuth is not authentication.
To be exact, OAuth is not user authentication nor message authentication. It sometimes does client authentication, but it shouldn't be confused with other types of authentication. Nonetheless, many people confuse it.
Including Facebook.
They did it many years ago with their mobile apps, and last week, one more such thing surfaced. Let me say it clearly in the beginning. OAuth can be used for user authentication, but requires a lot of thinking and additional security features over it. OpenID Connect is exactly something like that. So if you're considering an unfederated authentication system for yourself, then look at OpenID Connect. As of April 2018, over 92% of authentication federation at Microsoft Azure AD is OpenID Connect. You don't have to think, just go for it. Now, the rest of this episode is for those of you who won't understand the details. OAuth authorization server issues access token. Access token, as I have explained in previous episode, is an opaque string that carries the permission to access certain resource, such as your personal data or a part of your account. The legitimate client uses it to access the data, which is all good. Problem begins when an application starts to use it as if it is representing the resource owner's or the data subject's identity.
Remember, OAuth access token is usually given to somebody who is not the resource owner to be used against the resource owner's protected resource.
Actually, that's the whole point of OAuth. It is an access delegation protocol. I can hand my car's key to a valet. Yes, he can move and drive my car to park it in the car park and get it back to me. That's a great user experience, but it doesn't mean that valet is me. Absurd, right? But that's what happens often with OAuth authentication. Let's take an example of viewers feature of a certain large social network that disabled this feature recently. It offered a feature called view as specific person. Say that specific person was Alice. Using that feature, now the JavaScript app in the browser that I'm using got an access token that allocated the privilege granted to Alice when viewing my profile page, so that I can view how my profile page would look like from Alice. But the fact that I got this token does not mean I am Alice. However, in this particular case, there seems to be another app, video uploader app, that would interpret that I am Alice.
And happily escalated the privilege to the right operation.
Alice's account is now stolen.
Repeat this n times for other users. Now you have access token for many users.
What should that provider have done? First and foremost, it should have used ID token, not access token, to represent the user's identity, and should have solely relied on it as far as the user identification is concerned. That way, apps wouldn't have confused me with Alice. Secondly, it should have adhered to the principle of data minimization. This is a principle explained in ISO IEC 29100 privacy framework, and basically tells that each application should have the minimum privilege to get necessary data. It's an application of well-known privilege minimization principle to personal data. So, in this case, the token my JavaScript app got should only have the privilege to view my profile page with Alice's privilege. There are more points that can be raised, but I will save it for another episode. For now, remember this. Do not use stock OAuth for user authentication. Use OpenID Connect instead. Adhere to the minimum privilege principle. Hopefully this was useful. And don't forget to subscribe to this channel if you haven't done so yet. See you next time.